Good afternoon. I am Vanessa Thomas with the 4 o'clock news on the streets, 919 FM and online Facebook and YouTube, sponsored by TN Tech, the power to make it work. In the headlines, Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley receives praises from U.S. Embassy Deputy Chief of Mission. APT James will sail on Wednesday instead of Galleon's Passage. Licensing offices to remain closed until July 4th. And internationally, U.S. issues Japan travel warning weeks before Olympics. And now the news in detail. Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley came in for high praise from U.S. Embassy's Deputy Chief of Mission, Shanti Moore, for his engagement and consistent work with high-level U.S. officials in relation to acquiring COVID-19 vaccines not only for Trinidad and Tobago, but for all members of CARICOM. Mr. Moore highlighted the good work Dr. Rowley, as CARICOM chair, has done by engaging the United States government and Congress to advocate for vaccine equity globally. United States President Joe Biden recently announced that the U.S. will be donating 60 million doses of the AstraZeneca and 20 million doses of Moderna, Pfizer, and Johnson & Johnson vaccines to other countries in the month of June. The APT James will replace the Galleon's Passage on the Sea Bridge tomorrow, according to a new advisory issued by the Trinidad and Tobago Inter-Island Transportation Company Limited. The amended sailing schedule for tomorrow shows that the APT James will depart Port of Spain at 4 p.m. and depart Scarborough at 6:30 a.m. The TTIT also alerts passengers with tickets for the 8 a.m. sailing of the Galleon's Passage from Port of Spain tomorrow that they will be accommodated on the 4 p.m. sailing of the APT James from Port of Spain. In addition, those passengers with tickets for the 4 p.m. sailing of the Galleon's Passage from Scarborough tomorrow will be accommodated on the 6:30 a.m. sailing of the APT James from Scarborough. The Ministry of Works and Transport has advised that all licensing offices will stay closed until July 4th as a result of the ongoing state of emergency. In a media release, the ministry explained that those with existing appointments during this period of closure will be required to reschedule their appointments via the online scheduling portal on their website, utilizing date after July 4th, 2021. Given the demand for appointments, they're encouraging members of the general public to utilize all available time slots for licensing offices across TNT, even if your preferred location is unavailable. In addition, anyone whose driver's permits, taxi driver's license, badge, certificate, or other documents issued by the licensing division, which expired by January 1st, 2021, will now be deemed valid until October 1st, 2021. This may also be extended to a later date. Internationally, the U.S. has issued a travel warning for Japan over the country's COVID-19 surge amid heightened scrutiny just weeks before the Tokyo Olympics. The U.S. Center for Disease Control said travelers should avoid all travel to the country, warning that in the current situation in Japan, even fully vaccinated travelers may be at risk for getting and spreading COVID variants. U.S. Olympic officials have, however, said they are confident their athletes will be able to take part safely in the games. Japan has recorded more than 700,000 infections and 12,000 COVID-19 deaths from the virus and has already banned most travelers from entering the country. And that was the 4 o'clock news on the street, 919 FM, sponsored by TN Tech, the power to make it work. Recapping the headlines, Prime Minister Dr. Keith Rowley receives praises from the U.S. Embassy Deputy Chief of Mission. APT James will sail on Wednesday instead of the Galleon's Passage. Licensing offices to remain closed until July 4th, and internationally, U.S. issues Japan travel warning weeks before Olympics. Do keep it locked to the street, 919 FM. I am Vanessa Thomas. Good afternoon. Aisha Wells, she's up next.